Welcome to the Do-It-Yourself Hunter, sharing the know-how gained over years of hunting public and public accessible land in the U.S. We have proven that with the right information and hunting skills, you can hunt any game in North America. The goal is to pass along this knowledge, to share this great and ancient pursuit, especially with the young generation of men and women who are the future of hunting. We'll show you great hunts and share tips and tricks along the way that will make you a better outdoorsman. And now, the Do-It-Yourself Hunter.
Look here. Cut the hair on his back. Oh, not even a shot. That limb, I knew I could get under. Oh, I shot my 30-yard pin.
That's a heck of a deer, too.
I know. I got right there. He's just that's your tail. You must be getting him in. That's crazy. He's gonna go the other way.
Yeah, it was in it for him to die.
Where did the other thing go? He's still right there somewhere. Ain't
he? Yeah. My dang. Oh, I killed him right there.
I thought this was, I seen that first. You said there's a big bug. I like, if I'm gonna shoot him, no, I thought, well, I might. And then step down, I'm like, crap.
They were right. They were 40 yards from us when I seen
them. I bet that rattling I done.
Yeah.
I started to run anyway.
That's what I did. Get out there with them white horns in that field. I just couldn't tell how big he was then.
All right, let's go look at him. That was worth the trip, apparently. I think, yeah, we're going to do some good now. I think it ran into work.
Oh, yeah.
I believe he pulled young deer, ain't
he? I believe so.
Come on, G2. He's top and some limbs. And I can see through that limb. I'm like, man, he's that close. I gotta be able to hit him. I shot that sucker. Well, I shot a 30 yard pin. Well, I shot between my 20 and 30. He was aged out from the tree when I finally hit him. That first shot over, I just got there on top of his back on. There's a bow. I shot through it. Like you said, whack them, don't track them. You'll see, he didn't go very far. Deer Mississippi don't act like his. Heck, we ain't 10 feet off the ground. To be like in the wide open, that deer didn't even pay us a bit of attention in the world. Had a good wind, though. That's the key to it, get a good wind. He's laying right here, let's go look at him. South Dakota whitetail.
I guarantee.
I cut the hair on his back first shot. I don't know. I'd have shot high. Luckily, he just stood there and let us have another shot at him.
But, I thought it was over with.
Well, he stood around that dang brush pile over so dang long, but then got my heart got thumped pretty good.
Mine was too.
He finally come out. I'm like, well, I think I could. It was a little. I got drawn on his dang limb in a way, and I'm like, dang, well, I knew I'd shoot under him. Thought I could, and I shot over him. But I didn't hit no limb, I just shot high.
Well, that's a good-looking deer. We seen about 6 or 7 bucks this morning. He's moving good.
Most of them got across on the other side. One bad thing about this place, a lot of deer here is just, it's so old, you can't slip in here without busting them.
Yeah.
You know, it's lucky this one had the wind right, it was blowing that way, and he come from above. I'd done a little rattling trying to see if I could make him bucks cross the creek over there and look at us. And before I knew it, Larry said, heck, there's a buck here above us here. So I feel like he had to come in these horns. You about ready to get one now?
I'm ready to get one.
Oh, thanks. I believe something else is going to die here. We'll have to see.
I'm ready.
Let's get him out and everybody.
Let's make the trip worthwhile, don't it?
That's right.